Well, Doc, thank you for everything you have done for Jamaica, not the community, Jamaica. You have done a lot for us. And the dry dock thing, I want a whole heap of people get work, whole heap. I want to get work too, you know, but I want a whole heap of people get work. And I just want set of people forget work, everybody forget work. And some see it, everybody.
Cole stated that if the Cuban government beats us to the establishment of the dry dock system, we would have lost out on an amazing investment.
It will make all the difference. It will take us to another level of industry, sustainable industry. And as I said, shipping is here to stay. And the needs of shipping also goes with shipping is here to stay. And we are in the eye of the Panama Canal. I might just remind Jamaican as well, and for those who don't know, oil has been established in Cuba, the seventh largest oil reserve on earth. So I've been told, I saw that on CNN. I take this as gospel. I also saw pictures of the Chinese already installing their big rigs to explore oil off Cuba. Now, if we don't do this dry dock, the Chinese will do, because they will need a dry dock to begin with. Cuba will need it. So between Cuba and our China, they will build a dry dock. And guess what happened? Jamaica will be left out in the cold. I'll go a little further to tell you that if they build it, we have nothing to gain from it except minimum wage jobs. But if we build it, they won't need to build one. They'll use our facility and even invest in our facility because it will suit them as well. So it's a mega, mega amount of goodies awaiting us out there for Jamaica. Please, Jamaica, I beg you, don't let this opportunity. It's not a once-in-a-lifetime opportunity. It's a once-and-forever opportunity which will not repeat itself again if we miss it. Will not, I repeat itself if we miss it. And please, Jamaica, don't be afraid of big projects. Don't be afraid of big projects. Our small projects, bauxite is on the wane. I understand some of the big companies are moving their heavy-duty equipment already. In other words, it won't be too long before it's no longer economically viable to mine bauxite in Jamaica. Agriculture, well, we don't have enough arable lands for mechanized farming. Pickaxe, shovel, and machetes can't do it. And even what we produce, we're on a quota system everywhere. Banana, so many tons and no more at their price. Sugar, so many tons and no more at their price. We have a ceiling. We are hemmed in. Tourism, labile, as I say, it can take at any turn at any minute. Shipping is here to stay, and the needs for shipping, including medical facilities right in Jamaica to facilitate anything that happens onward with passengers on board. Not to mention, the tourist industry will take off at a different level as well. Business tourism, I've been to Hong Kong and I had problems getting a hotel room there. The government of China had to book it for us because the businessmen are there in numbers. Business tourism are there in numbers. So things like these attract business tourism in a vast scale. We have a good thing going, Jamaica. Please, Jamaica, we have a good thing going for us. Lap it up. Don't miss it. Cuba will if we don't. I might as well add that it won't be long that Cuba becomes the Singapore of the Caribbean. We are seeing changes in Cuba at the moment that are tending towards that. If and when, and I think Obama, President Obama, gets a second term, he will have no need to fear the Republicans because he won't be going for a third term. An executive order to lift the embargo of Cuba will turn Cuba overnight into a Singapore of the Caribbean. And Jamaica will be there, as they say, gasping for breath. Minimum jobs might not even be available for Jamaica. Cuba will take it and run with it. Businessmen are on the fence waiting for the day Cuba is free. It won't be long. It's not even in the interest of the Republicans to continue this embargo on Cuba. It's not in their interest. So watch out, Cuba. Watch out, Jamaica. Cuba is on our heels. This dry dock will dampen all that, whatever it doesn't have in store for us. Cuba will take it and run with it, and we'll be left in the cold. We can't afford to.
Job creation is high on the agenda. Over 5,000 jobs are slated to be created with the initiation of this project.
Immediate jobs, on site. If you start building, contracts is going, and immediately at least 5,000 people will be on site in high-paid, high-profile and other types of jobs. They will in turn spread the joy to other people so that hundreds and thousands of other people will be employed at the same time. And that's exponential. That will go on in terms of jobs expanding as various other industries coalesce around the dry dock and even far away. Now, because of the magnitude of such a project, we will need land space for offshore industries. And that's where a lot of goodies will happen as well. And I might say the takeoff for Jamaica will be even before a brick or a block is laid. The takeoff will be when an official announcement is made that this project is for real. Then there are folks now, businessmen and others, who will have to line up to get a piece of the action. So business will start immediately. It is announced officially that this thing is for real. And it is for real. But we want to hear it from government. I hope the minister, and this is through the grapevine, will be making an announcement shortly. And you might see a lot of difference. And I appeal to Jamaica, talk it on the radio, on the television, everywhere, that we need a dry dock. We need it. I cannot see anything else on the horizon that could make such a difference to Jamaica. I can't at the moment. Somebody else maybe can. I can't.
The Cole revealed the source of the inspiration that led him to devise the project.
While I was doing a ward round in Jubilee, incidentally started there, in Jubilee, in between a ward round, I just took up the map of the world and took a look at Jamaica's position in relation to the Panama Canal. And noting in the back of my mind that Jamaica is not doing as well as it ought to and can do. And with that in mind, I thought, well, what are we doing about the Panama Canal and all these ships passing us by the minute? And these ships need servicing facilities of one type or the other. What are we on earth doing about it? And there it started, in Jubilee. Then I drew a map of it, took it to Jamaica House, and the Prime Minister, Mr. Pattison, was right there on it. He invited all the big guys to a meeting, and we appear to have taken off from there.
A man of strong resolve and manifest vision, Cole finds contentment in simple pleasures through the creation of music and artwork. When asked what continues to motivate him despite the many negative stories we hear about Jamaica every day, to continue to support and sponsor youth and development, this is what Dr. Lloyd Cole had to say.
I love Jamaica too much to see our young boys and our young girls walking on the street begging for money and begging for a job which does not exist. People, some of them who get in university, come out, can't find a job. I have this problem here daily. People coming, giving me a resume. And what do I do? I can't do anything about it. There's no jobs. And they sit on the corner doing absolutely nothing, just waiting for the nightfall to go and involve in crime and other things. I hate that. I cannot stand it. I beg Jamaica. I plead with the rulers, people in high places, the movers and shakers. It's not for Lloyd Cole, rather. It's for Jamaica, land we love.
I believe the children are our future. Teach them well and let them lead the way. Show them all the beauty they possess inside. Them a sense of pride to make it easier. Let the children's laughter remind us how we used to be. Everybody searching for a hero. People need someone to look up to. I never found anyone who fulfilled my needs. So I